Hi, this is Alex Tardy, a meteorologist here at the National Weather Service office in San Diego. This is a video weather briefing for the period Thursday through Monday. This is issued January 9th. The following slides will give you a depiction of the weather expected over the next few days, including the wind, the cold temperatures, and some precipitation and low snow levels. Hope you enjoy the presentation. Here's a look at the highlights of the weather we're expecting when the cold front comes through on Thursday. Windy conditions developing Thursday and continuing into Thursday night. There will be precipitation with the front. Strongest impacting winds will be in the mountain passes, canyons, and also in the desert slopes. Snow levels will crash to below 3,000 feet on Thursday. We'll also see gale force winds over the open waters developing, along with the high surf and the high tide near 7 feet, which will occur in the morning hours. Freezing temperatures will be an impact for Thursday night in wind-sheltered areas. And then really our coldest night is expected to be Friday night as the winds decrease significantly. Our outlook for Monday looks like there'll be another storm coming from our north and western Canada all the way down California in a similar track and bring us similar cold temperatures and wind. All right, graphically, let's look at what the highlights are. Cold and windy on Thursday. There's our cold front that'll come barreling through Southern California Thursday morning. As we mentioned in the prior slide, impacts will include a brief period of precipitation. It will be locally heavy, however, in the mountains. We'll see some strong winds develop ahead of the front and continue behind the front. Coastal areas will have increasing surf and increasing seas as strong winds pick up behind the cold front over the coastal areas. Snow levels will be an impact even Thursday morning as they crash down to below 3,000 feet. Travel across the passes will be impacted because of this. Here's a look to the right of the other impacts that will be occurring. Minor tidal erosion as we expect high tide to reach around 7 feet. All right, here's a look at our weather story that'll depict the cold front on the left coming through Thursday morning and the impacts that we talked about on the right of this image. To the far right, we'll see the impacts of the high surf, the strong winds developing gale force gusts over the open waters, and of course the high tide that'll occur especially Thursday morning all the way through Saturday when it could exceed 7 feet. Here's our jet stream pattern or the storm track that'll drive these storms through Southern California. On Thursday, a very sharp storm system will bring probably the coldest air mass of the season across Southern California as it swings through. Then another system is expected on Monday now. Looks to take a similar storm track right from the north in western Canada all the way down into Southern California. And that is expected to occur on Monday with similar windy conditions and cold temperatures. This is what the satellite looked like today. The cold front is depicted in the yellow and blue cold clouds that are stretched out across the west coast. The really cold air behind it, as you can see all those speckled areas of white clouds, that's the cold air mass that'll be swinging through our region on Thursday and Thursday night. How much precipitation with the cold front on Thursday? Well, most areas will see a little bit of light rain in the hours of Thursday morning. However, mountain areas and a few heavier showers along the coast will see heavier precipitation as depicted here. The mountains most affected appear to be the San Bernardino Mountains, where several inches of snow will accumulate and impact several of the highways up there as shown on this map. We also do expect a little bit of accumulating snow for the I-15 Pass and Cajon Pass and down on Interstate 8 up around 4,000 feet as it cuts through San Diego County. Those will be our main impacts with the snowy conditions across the mountains on Thursday. Here's our basic weather map depicting the cold front as it swings through Thursday morning. Keep in mind, wind will be developing out ahead of it, especially in the desert slopes and the mountain passes. And the strongest winds right behind the cold front and increasing as shown here across the coastal waters and really across all of our deserts and mountain passes all the way through Thursday night. Here is a depiction of our forecast wind gusts. These are peak wind gusts. The areas in orange and red, that'll be our strongest wind across the mountain passes and the desert slopes of the mountains. That includes Riverside, San Bernardino, and San Diego counties, including Interstate 10 and Interstate 8 being affected. These are images for Thursday morning, 7 a.m. and 10 a.m. specifically, as the winds increase. We'll also be looking at wind increasing behind the front Thursday afternoon. As shown here, the orange, yellow, and even some red increasing wind across the open waters near gale force gusts in those areas. Also note the winds that really increase behind the cold front and the upper deserts and continue right through the afternoon. This will really affect all of our major interstate passes, including 15, 10, and Interstate 8. Winds are expected to continue in a lot of the desert areas and over the open waters right through Thursday night. The other story is the very cold temperatures, probably the coldest air mass of the season. We'll see a lot of freezing temperatures in the Inland Empire and some of the inland valleys during Thursday night into Friday morning. Look at the cold temperatures in the mountains getting down into the low single numbers, even below zero in some of the coldest locations. Now for Friday night, we do expect lighter winds, so a lot of areas will be colder, including the deserts, even the Inland Empire, and noticeably along the coast, Orange Coast and San Diego coast, where temperatures could get near freezing in a lot of places. Well, thanks for watching this weather briefing video presentation. Here are some links that you can follow to weather forecast graphics, the first link. You can also look at real-time temperature and wind observations, as well as precipitation on the next link on a Google map. And then for all the hazards, the watches, warnings, and advisories that are in effect, use the link number 3. Thanks for tuning in, listening to the National Weather Service in San Diego.